So yeah, I guess so today, I don't know, I didn't want to talk about the age gap marriage problem, but it is a problem for other people. I noticed in the press they're going weirdo on the new presidente of France. I don't know. It seems like though there's always going to be like a scandal set with people that have children versus the people who don't have children. So remember that always. So when you have an age gap marriage, like with an older woman especially, and there are no children, you're just a scandal already. By not even the age gap, just not having the children. So when you don't have the children and then you have the age gap, you're just going to be finger pointed at by the vast majority. So the vast majority is just like, you're wrong, you're wrong, you're wrong, because this is our little circle we run in, you know, we run in our little circle set. And here's my little, you know, here's my little toy, and I roll in that little toy every day. That's it. And so in that action, I know I'm starting to work on jewelry, silly me. I'm terrible at it, but wire wrapping, they call it. I don't know. I'm giving up on Emile de Meliza. That particular song, it's just like I get into the like the last three quarters of it and it just drops out of me. I cannot keep that. It has like a momentum in it. And you just have to keep it up, and I can't keep that momentum up. I'm so, well, anyway, sad for opera. You're gonna miss that one in with me. And you know what? Oddly, I thought I could sing it, but as soon as the words, oh, am I supposed to say congratulations? Of course, félicitations, le nouveau président, Emmanuel Macron. Yeah, félicitations. So here we are, and we're like, well. He has an older wife. Oh my gosh. Just like my funny age gap marriage. And mine is only like 7 years. Seven and a half. You know, is nothing compared to her. So, I mean, I think you all need to lay off. That's pretty rude of everybody. You know, and then I think about marriage, you know, what it's all about, and my gosh, sometimes it's money, motivations, like marry, sometimes not. There was no money motivation in my marriage, none at all. It was just adventure. We just wanted to travel and get out of business, and yet we ended up in business, and then get out of business, and then travel and get out of business. Yeah, I mean, you know, so oddly, motivations sometimes are just different, you know, and the one no children is a very big motivation. Even though I myself, particularly, I hit that bell number, the 38 or whatever, and I'm just like, well, that's it. I have to have a child. I have to have a child. And I went nuts, and I used that thermometer, and every day, what temperature am I? Am I ovulating and all of this? All of these ridiculous things, you know, because that's the success as a woman by the general population, you know, if you're not that pregnant female that has given birth, you're just not a success to them. They look at you as estranged. You're the estranged populace, yeah. So that's who these age gap marriages are with the older women. I'm not going to talk about the age gap marriages of the older men at all. Just the older women. And you can say, well, we have a Fausta complex, okay? And I do have the Fausta in my line, so that does kind of go through to ring a bell. If you know the story of her, it was kind of interesting. She went with her husband's son from another marriage and blah blah blah, and then he ended up dead, and they ended up having to kill him because the husband of Fausta was how should we say it? You know, it was just a terrible. Was it terrible for him? You know, it's like an ego, you know, destroy. So yeah, so he killed the son. I'm not sure if he did it or he ordered him killed, but I don't know, a lot of weirdo things going on. I saw a little glimpse of, I don't like to give critique to opera, but I guess they're going on and on about this new production of Magic Flute. They call it Magic Flute here, Mozart's. And oh my gosh, I just thought it was awful. I will say straight out, I don't like anything like that. In the back of the screen, of course, it competed with the music score. It was an insult, visually. It was an insult to dedicated brain cells that wanted to be there and participate. The last people who were there in the audience clapping, they were an insult also. I was insulted that the audience is such a leader-follower syndrome here in San Francisco that they just couldn't just say, hey, not here ever again. It was awful. Okay, so when we start to get to like abacadabra style for an opera, and we're like at what? Six Flags amusement park, and the people are in their $1,000 outfits, and they're supporters of the arts, culture, remember, instead of destruction of the brain cells of the human species. Culture. When fine culture gets a kick like that, it's almost like, well, wait a minute, maybe there's an ulterior motive. Maybe there's an agenda to destroy opera itself, to destroy the cultural arts themselves. I have to step back and look at it and go, I have a feeling that was an intentional kill. You know what I'm saying? That was an intentional destroy of a good and wonderful thing. So, yeah, Satan Mino, I don't think so. That was awful. Just awful. And I'm sure there are some critics out there that were true and honest and gave a true and honest critique. And I'm really hoping so. I cannot believe people are that gullible to swallow that garbage. I just can't believe it. Okay, so that was my critique. Yeah, there's a lot of uproar about it's the downgrade, you know, the downgrading of opera. When you take opera and you downgrade it, and you downgrade it, and you downgrade it. You know, you just make it a street event. I've danced in the street in my pointe shoes before, for money. I you know, it's not something to idolize. It's not something you want to participate in. It's just not great to be a circus venture on the street. Okay. And unfortunately, that's what they are doing to opera. And I'm like, what? Pay for those tickets? No, I don't think so. I think those would be like not that price. I think that would be not even half price. I think that would even be, oh my gosh, I'm suing you. You gave me epilepsy. It was that type of production. So, yeah, never again. Never again. So, yeah, I don't really want to go there. I don't ever want to go to San Francisco Opera or any of you people there. I just think something is a little suspicious. It's a little suspicious, a little too rock the boat here, a little just kick the arts out altogether. I didn't like that. Okay. So, where are we at? With my roundup here. Oh, we can't have roundup anymore, apparently. I did hear that, a glimpse of it. The roundup product, believe it or not, has been proven to give this Hodgkin's lymphoma to people. And so, oh my gosh. They're, yeah. Okay, so the people who have Hodgkin's lymphoma can now sue the Roundup poison chemical company. So it's all become a hello, don't use it. Yeah. Because it's a little too late. Once you get into lawsuits, it's just a little too late. You're already about dying. So yeah, better not to use the product. What else did I have to say? Oh my gosh, my voice was a lot better in France, a lot better when I was living in Corsica, a lot better when I was living in near, oh gosh, where is that town? Actually, not that area. There was another area. It was really good. And it was like a house itself. It was like the house made me sing. I just started singing out of the blue. We moved there and I just started singing. I just started doing scales. And I'm like, well, that is so funny. It's almost like the house had a rhythm. You know what I mean? The house had singers in it before and it was used to it or something. I don't know. I just got a catchy bug that I just had to sing. And I started there. And that house, yeah, I had a little pond. Wasn't the last place I lived, but it was a good property. It had a really good large garden, and oh my gosh, I don't really want to be a realtor, but yeah, it was a very good cottage garden started. So yeah, I know my fingernails aren't so great right now. They're not done. They're not beautiful for showing you all my funny little. I don't know. These are, you know, I can try to make more, what do you call it, elegant. I made this type of little earrings. But, you know, I don't know. I don't know where I'm going with it. The wire wrapping. Yeah, they can be kind of fun. I have a lot of beads and things already. So it's kind of interesting to start. Yeah, I don't know, this whole drama with age, the age dissidents. I think the fashion of the older man and the younger woman, it really is a fashion that has been sold just for years and years and years and years and years. And then there's always been the odd marriages with a very political woman and an age gap of a younger man. There has always been that, all throughout history. Cleopatra, my gosh, she was notorious. So, why are the peasants scowling at her? How dare they? How dare they? Congratulations to her that she has a younger man and that she's kept him this long. You know? I'm like I think President Zumi has one, a long marriage of 38, or no, I don't know. I don't think it's President Zumi. There was another one, though. And they have an estranged marriage, but a big age gap. And yeah, so there are a few out there, and they just call themselves estranged, and that's that. And it's happiness for them, and that's enough. And that should just be enough for the public. The public doesn't need to know anymore. They don't need to know, oh my gosh, can we see your bedroom? They don't need to know any of that. They know way too much already. So, yeah. Anyway, what a bunch of sillies. My gosh. So, yay. Or what was I gonna say? I'm signing off, and I'm even though I learned all the words to I you know I learned all the words to Mild und leise, wie lächelt, and all of that, you know, wie das Auge oder öffnet, yeah, sieht ihres nicht, all of that. Oh, you know, it's a great song. But oh my gosh, oh my gosh, I can't, I don't have that. I don't have that hold and forte. It has to have a hold and forte. you know. So yeah, I'm kind of sad about it because I thought I had a little bit of prowess to make it through. Darn it. Yeah. So that's my big woo-woo at the moment. And what else was I working on? Oh, I started Depuis les Jours, and that one is just like, oh my gosh, another one that is just, ooh, I don't know, another one. Yeah, that one is a toughie. It's a tough one, like, scale-wise. It really, really takes a strong voice for it. Not a heavy voice, though. Not a heavy voice. Gosh dang it. I'm working on an Ave Maria. I got that one going okay. It's not great. But yeah, I got that one. What else? What else have I got? Oh my gosh. Oh yeah, I could tell you my songs. Achik Fools is doing pretty good. Achik Liebte, I love. May not be great, but I love it. Vedrai Carino. What's the another song I like? Oh, Dove Sono. D'Andrea. I have got that one down now, O Quante Volte. And I didn't think I was, but I've got it all by myself, and I don't need any helper, singer. I've got it all through. I'm so happy with that one. I may not be the greatest on it, but my gosh, I'm very happy. I'm very happy to succeed on O Quante Volte. So that makes me very, very, very female feeling. That's one of my highest songs. Yeah, one of my highest songs, soprano-wise. I've got the Custa Diva thing, working on the ending. Oh, what's that other one? I'm working on Col Chorizo. Now that one... yeah, that one I'm getting through. I'm getting through. What's that other one? Qui la voce. Yeah, Qui la voce is not a problem. And Anon credea mirate has been a problem. There's a lot of lag gags in the end that I haven't been able to get through. So I've kind of put that one on pausa. So yeah, that's my bel canto range. That one is kind of missing. Okay, and then over, I have a lot of songs that I run through. I have what's that other one? Inkeltrine Morbide is great. I really love that one. That one's going swell. Eco respiro appena. Eco Respiro Apeña is becoming really, really fun. Mora at the end. Dia Mora. See, where am I at? Where am I at? Gosh, I love opera. I don't think I'm ever going to perform it, but I love it. And I shouldn't say that. And I did buy myself a dress already. But it doesn't mean I'm going to perform it. It just means I bought myself a dress. And then I'm like, well, the dress is kind of old, fogey looking, and so I'm not happy with it, so I'm trying to make it more beautiful. Anyway, and so, oh, what else? Vocalise. I love Vocalise, but I'm not as great as Mofa. Anna Mofa. Mofo. Is that Mofo? Anna Mofo. She's great in her Vocalise. She has a real soft section in the middle that is very beautiful. I loved Adam Kiri also. Her vocalise is very good. It's very, very you know, it just gets you like, that's it. You know, that's practically a medicine. I didn't want to say her voice is showing me that it's a medicine, but the way she stands, she is very, very strict in that training, and it's just helpful. It's just helpful. So yeah, look at hers. Okay, and now where else am I? I'm doing also that little cutesy crepuscule, comme un redu, sur la blanchade. That one. A little cutesy song. Where else am I? Oh, I love to talk about my songs. It's ridiculous. Poveri Fiori. Oh my gosh. O mio dolce adore. O mio dolce adore. Bramato Oggetto, that one. Which else? I'm also going with, I have, there is that one, you know, I dropped Traviata at the moment because it has a section in the middle that I'm just not strong enough for on my own. I'm strong with the listener, as a listener singer, but not on my own, so I dropped that one. I'm looking at, Forse Lui Che Anima, I have that one. Not Fully, Not Sempre, Estrano, yes. And what's the other one? Un Bel Di Vit, a lot of Puccini's. Puccini's are easier. Un Bel Di Vitremo, the Si Mi Chiamo Mimi, and all of that. Donde Lieta, I've learned recently, so I'm happy with that one. Oh my gosh. Oh, mio bambino, caro, all of that. I'm working on sola perduta abbandonata. Abbondata. Sola perduta abbondata. That one's wonderful. I love that song. It's really gut wrenching. Yeah, Iri novelle. Delta. Oh my gosh, I can't say it out of the blue, but yeah, it gets exciting. Which other one? Where was I at? There's another one. I haven't finished. I know I have another song in there. Please tell me I do. Oh yeah, Tucce. Tucce di gel de seicinta. That one. Signore ascolta vise d'arte. And Senza Mama, I guess I can work on that one. But that's a long learn. Oh my gosh. And I have a lot of like the regular, like those ones. The more, what do you call them, more religious songs. But they're not really, they're short. You know, Ombra is a short song, unless you sing it like they do in the schools. And I don't have all those lyrics, and I don't think I have that many brain cells to learn the full Ombra, just the little bits, you know, with the four stanzas. What's that other one? Oh, Cujus Animentum. Cujus, yeah. Anime Gementum, that's a good one. I love that song. Constritatum, Edolatum, all of that. And then there's the other one. Oh, da-ra-ra. I can't even think of it right now, but yeah, the other one, the sad song. There's a Morientum, Desolatum, Vidit sum, that's it, vidit sum, yeah, dulcem natum, that one. Anyway, so yeah, I don't know, not great, that's all I can say, I get through it. I was better, isn't that strange to say? I think, I don't know, is it age? My voice is just wants to give up. Ugh, darn it. Gosh, dang it, I really had so much. I just got through Carmen recently. That's an easy one. Except I can't find the instrumentals for the full Carmen. L'amour, that one. I can't find the full, the Habanera. Yeah, I can't find the all of the songs. So I'm missing the second half. So, yeah. And then that one with the Traviata, what do you call that one where they're Addio, Addio del passato, Besogne ridenti, yeah, Le Rose de Volta, that one. Yeah. So I'm having fun with Traviata, but then I fall out on Folie. It's all that joy. Anyway, Dandria. Yeah, it's really fun actually to start opera when you're like 40. When did I start? I don't know, 45 maybe. And just like, you know, let's go through opera and menopause all at once. You know, it's just hysterical. Why not? Anyway. Yeah, what a cutie. We have a cutie little president for France. So let's be happy, women. Alrighty. Alright. Ciao.